Hey all, time to do some Buddy. And on the PT channel we went through this one, but somebody wanted to see it without a capo. I don't know why beginners are afraid of capos. They actually make things simpler to play a lot of times. But we're going to go through it this way with the capo. Let's walk through it, right? I got the capo at 4, but it doesn't really matter. I was tuned with this guitar. I was tuned down to, I think I was playing some Hendrix the other day. So I just sort of found a standard pitch and ended up fiddling around with the tuning to get it capoed at the 4th. But it doesn't matter where you put the capo. Just tune so that your low E at this, whether you're at 5, 4, 3 or wherever you are. If you want to play in tune with Buddy, that's what your low E has to be. So put the capo wherever you need it. So the main thing is, right, that's on the G string, 3 to 4. And then walk all the way down. B7. Well, it's not a B7, but the shape is a B7. A, you're on A. Then E. I'm calling them E and A, but you know, with the capo. That'll be the day on E, and then B7, E. Back to A. F sharp 7 to B7, back to A. That'll be the day. This is the chorus. That'll be the day. That'll be, rests on E. That'll be the day. B7, E. Okay, so that, the solo. The high E at that's on the 3rd fret on the high E and the B. up B, a G and B. So G is at 4, B is at 3. And then the G goes 4, 2, 0. So for those last couple, he adds in that high E string at 1, 2, 3, 4. So you're doing a full... full-blown E7 chord. It's a D7 shape, moved up two frets. Back to A. This is still during the guitar solo. There's no actual soloing this part. He just rests on the rhythm. E. Between those and then B7, A7. So that's a regular A, and then 7 it by doing the high E at the third, and then off. So coming out of it, back to E, and then same as the intro. Back into another one of those. And I don't know if there's anything different except for at the very end it goes. Take that G at 4, B at 3, and slide it all and walk it all the way down to an E chord. I think that's the whole tune, isn't it? I think so. If you have any trouble, let me know. But if you really are guessing on the fret thing or don't understand the capo concept, I can't really help you with that. It doesn't matter where you're tuned or how you're tuned or whether you're in standard or higher than standard or lower than standard. It doesn't matter. Put the capo wherever it belongs so that your E sounds like this. And if that is somewhere in between the cracks, and I think when I slapped the capo on and then went to get tuned to it, it was in between the cracks for me. So I just fiddled with it till there's an E shape with a capo. That's what you need, because you're going to play it with an E shape. So you really got to get the... It's like the early Beatles period when they used to say, oh, the rhythm's in the guitar. It really is. So good luck with that. Let me know if you have any trouble.